Because the agriculture sector is so important for us as a human being to survive. Back to 2016, there was a very famous event in the UK. There was lots of news report about the huge labor shortage in the agriculture sector. And then that make me thinking, maybe some technologies we developed in the automotive industry can be transferred into agriculture industry. I realized, oh my gosh, it's not only the labor shortage, the growers, the farmers, are facing so many different pressures. Instead of to make the big machines, we make much smaller, much lighter machines. But because we have the capability to make it autonomous, so we can make many of them. So in that way, we are more like ants. Each individual one is small, not that super powerful, but when we have a fleet of ants, we can really work together to do lots of work.
Our relationship with growers has been vital, you know, and we didn't have an agricultural background, so we were relying on them to show us how they grow, to show us their current problems. They want to grow more sustainably, and at the moment, they don't have that many tools available. So that relationship for us has been so important. They're realizing that, you know, that the future has to have robotics there for future generations.
We have been always looking about the automation, and we've done a lot of automation with our systems. We're using, for example, different sensors in the back, controlling the climate as much as possible, but we haven't done much in terms of actual robots. The current project is UV treatment of the plants, and hopefully, fingers crossed, have it all treated with UV instead of chemicals. So we've reduced our herbicide use to zero. So we don't use any herbicides. And now the last element of the pesticides are left is the fungicides. UV kills bacteria and fungus, but we have to get it right to actually help the plant. If we are successful in this project, we can proudly say we will be, you know, offering to the market a pesticide-free produce.
Our vision is to make this robotics, automation, and digitization for everyone, not just for large, big commercial farms, but also for smaller, medium-sized farms.
So platform on its own, you could technically say is the core product itself. Then we have logistics platform, which is assist function, essentially.
Assist is primarily meant to help harvesting. They spend about 20% of their time walking from where they've just picked fruit to where they just drop it off. And they would prefer to be spending that time picking, because that's where the money's made.
In terms of other products, Insight, we're looking to really reduce the waste. For example, at the moment, is currently inaccurate scouting methods. They can have way more fruit than they realized. So we're looking to give them that data as early as possible. Through that collection of data at scale, if there's areas of low productivity, you know, low yield, the AI can find those areas and the farmer can have a look and see why.
The most important for us is the actual Antobot platform, which we can, you know, put many other attachments, and with the same platform and everything, we could do multiple jobs.
From a farmer's perspective or our end user's perspective, they don't necessarily want the robot to be pretty, but they do want the function and they want the durability. They don't necessarily want to think about the robots on a daily basis, other than that it's doing what it's meant to be doing.
One thing that's really unique about our software is the modularity of it. So because we've built everything on top of our robot platform, you can sort of swap in and out hardware bits, but still the core part is the same. We really pride ourselves on having it be compatible with different modes, different applications, and different services.
Biggest challenge is sometimes going into a field like this, for example, not knowing what to expect, not always having your requirements set correctly, or not set at all. So we often find problems in the fields that we weren't even aware of before we came here. So it's always a bit of a who gets the first go, whether we make changes in software to make up for hardware limitations or the other way around.
In terms of interacting with the mechanical team, we always need the robots to be functioning well, have all of the hardware that we need on board, and we need it to be robust.
Having used SolidWorks, it does make things easy. It's a very intuitive software to use. It's easy to make changes to designs. We could come here today, have an issue, go back straight away, design something new, and then come back tomorrow with a new part already. It makes the process very fast for us, which in this industry is very important.
So for us, this is essential. Otherwise, we cannot get this built for robots out. Yeah, I think the SolidWorks startup program is excellent. It's a perfect program for us because we, as a startup, we have limited resources. We really need someone to help us to get on with our design so we can really hit the ground and keep running.
We were basically in a position where we had a project, but we needed 3D software, and then sort of had a quick look around and then came across this startup program from Solid Solutions for a very young startup at that point as well, especially being so capital limited, if you will. Being able to have the full package free of charge for the first year was brilliant. And also Solid Solutions and SolidWorks don't really throw the startups into the deep end after that either. So they do help you out in the following years as well.
Opportunities in this domain, we found it's huge. At this moment, we would like to focus in the UK market because we found the UK is really, really innovative on the agri-tech space, so even beyond Europe, because this problem is not UK or Europe unique, it's global. Even countries like China, we consider it's like a country with huge of labor source, but they are hitting into the labor crisis very shortly. There is no young people getting into this industry. As we can imagine, there will be a huge labor shortage and demands on agriculture robots. So this would be also the future markets we would expand into as well.